come into this land and into the earth. She ain't getting away, huh? She ain't getting away at all. Trust me. Trust me, huh? She ain't getting away.
That's one girl.
Because these women, they don't have sheep. They don't have sheep. This is Sarah, who had a 6 and 23. You see a wicked woman. Sorry, 25. A shamefaced, a shameless woman shall be counted as a dog. You understand? That, because watch at a woman. You don't have no shame. They wear anything they want. They talk to the man or the husband how they want. They talk to the children how they want. They don't even honor their mother and their father.
And they love gossip.
Yeah, they love the gossip.
Love gossip.
You think about everything wrong, these women like it. They love it. Right? You even try to break down some scripture to them, they, yo, you shouldn't do this. They like, nah, I don't believe that. Yeah, you're reading it to them, and they don't believe it. Death to them.
And they took me on each other's back like normal too, man.
Because
they took me on each other's back.
I'm sorry about that.
Yeah.
Watch out this, brethren. Look, this week I was in a debate on work with some of these Israelite sisters and them who call themselves Africans and Trinidadians. And these things are showing them out of the law. What is their responsibility? Who they are? They reject that. As a Trinidadian, I don't care what you tell me.
Yeah.
I don't care what you tell me. As a Trinidadian, yeah. And they're despising the law of God. And this young girl rise up with braids. So my supervisor asked me, "What do you think about women with braids and these things?" I said, "That is not according to the law. That is not according to the law of the Most High God." And I remember what the elders always say, they always want a real man, but false hair, false nail, and this girl rise up.
Everything about them false.
She rise up. She didn't like what I was saying to her. She rise up. You can see, like, it make me remember with King Herod and John the Baptist. So when Herod tell, when King John the Baptist to tell Herod about your brother wife, and you see the treacherousness in this woman, and she rise up and she was not pleased. And then what she's saying, "Well, I have something here. If you get down on that, it will make you to forget the law." I say, you're mad over. I said that when the most I curse even the Israelite black woman, the Israelite woman pussy too. They say, "What?" I say, "Yes, the most I curse all her and curse all the pussy too." Yeah? You telling a man of God, you have something that will cause me to forget the law so I could buy weed for you? I say, your man don't know the law. If your man know the law, he will not entertain that stupidness. And you know what I do, Zika? I keep myself away from her. Yeah, I was shy, awesome, taught us that. Certain things you keep away from the Jews and them. Something you gotta keep yourself away, because remember, they're coming in a way not to help you, but they're coming in a way to destroy you. Yeah.
Proverbs 9, verse 13. A foolish woman is clamorous. She is simple and knows nothing.
Yeah. Simple and knows nothing. And that way we are the men of God. We have to guard ourselves and stand firm. She believe her pussy have more power than the Most High law to cause you to turn away from the Most High. Go on, brother.
This is Ecclesiastes.
Yeah. If you get down here and you taste that, you will spend all your money and buy weed for me.
Yeah.
This is Ecclesiastes 7 and 24. As thou daughters have care for their body, and show not thyself cheerfully towards them.
Repeat that again?
Go on, brother.
Ecclesiastes 7:24. As thou daughters have care for their body.
Yeah, that's what's going on. These fathers is not watching over their daughters. That's why they are all over in the savannas in the park talking shit to other young men. Because the father is not in their life.
That's right.
You need, a daughter needs a male figure in her life, a father figure. And these women is raising up their daughters.
Okay, so back that up, you could ask them too, but like, damn, where's your father? The mother don't know where the daughter is. The sister don't know where the sister is.
They popping these nigga bitches.
Yes.
And leaving them and not handling any responsibility. That's in Deuteronomy 28.
Sister going messing.
Go ahead, finish reading that.
And show not thyself cheerfully towards them.
Yeah, so don't show yourself cheerfully towards your daughter, man. It's a balance you gotta have with your daughter. Understand? Sometimes you're gonna be harsh with them, sometimes you're gonna be cool, but mostly harsh. Because girls, man, shit. They ain't easy, man. Now, for real. Now, this is a book by Nature Knows No Color Line. Listen to these brothers. It said Nature Knows No Color Line by Jay Rogers. During the Dark Ages, this is what brothers were saying about women back then in the Dark Ages. Right? I'm going to bring out some pointers. I already highlighted. Listen, a nut, a donkey, and a woman needs the whip. So if you see a brother whipping his wife, man, hey man, stand back, man. There's a reason why she getting her ass whooped. There's a video out here where a husband was beating up his wife in the bar. Hey, she might have committed adultery. There wasn't no audio sign to that video. She might have been committing adultery. Homeboy got pissed and started kicking her on her ribs in the head. Is that a smart thing to do in this kingdom? No, I won't suggest that. Because we'll get locked up. The laws is on the black woman's side. This black woman could lie on you till one of us raped her and we get locked up for her lies. Understand? Now, she's in pact with Satan, man. Alright? This black woman is against us. Eve was against Adam. So let me continue what this book say right here. There is nothing worse in the world. Listen. There is nothing worse in the world than a woman be she never so good. I'm gonna say a woman's not so good. She's not good at all. I dare nigga say my wife is perfect. My wife is the best. Get the fuck out of here, man. Get the fuck out of here, man. Everybody wives evil. Some just have greater evil than others.
I can say that with mine. I can say that with mine because this morning again, they turned on them ready and I told her to something that she did and she get offended and get displeased. And she know that she had to strap me on with this child and she just walk out and go her way.
Yeah,
she just walk out and
24.
Go her way.
Yep. You know?
Because I tell her what she's doing is wrong. And pretend something that she turned on it to eat. She get offended for that.
These women got bad attitude, man. That's why scripture said, in thy power, they're gonna be willing, man. When we get our power, that's when they're gonna bow down and be submissive, man. You know what I'm saying? But I'm gonna tell you one thing, man. A lot of brothers' wives is gonna die. And the husband might put their wives to death. If the Most High put it in Peter's glass and said, kill your wife, you better fucking do it. You better do it. You better do it. Chop that bitch head off one fucking time.
The crowd, the order, the Most High.
Well, what you ask?
Ecclesiasticus, chapter 25 and verse 24. Of the woman came the beginning of sin.
Of the woman became the beginning of what? Of sin, man. You got a woman in this job, say, man, you taste this pussy, man.
Yeah.
In other words, she gonna make him fall out the truth. But hey, believe it or not, some brothers did fall out the truth for pussy, huh? Different brothers around the world, huh? I ain't falling out the truth for no fucking pussy, man. Not for no pussy at all. Even your pussy made out of gold.
Platinum.
If your pussy smell like roses or fucking they not. I could claim you're gonna be mine in the kingdom.
Not to fall out of the truth.
Not to fall out of the truth, man. Fuck that shit.
I have to buy hair weave.
you have something more?
And through her, we all die. And through her,
we all die. Yeah, through her, man, we all die, man.
Because if you really follow her,
yes, she will bring death.
She's destroying us.
That's right.
It's destruction she bring it to us.
That's right.
Huh?
That is so right.
If you only listen to her.
So people are on the app. Check these women underneath this kingdom. When they speak, when they instructing something, is not to give glory to the Most High God. It's always leading to the way of flesh destruction. Always to please themselves and not to honor the Most High God. I can tell you that because I see that with my wife. Yeah? And these women, there's not giving glory to the Most High God. They're not acting like the holy woman and them. But the scripture said that they're supposed to hold it.
Yep.
Yeah?
But when you run across some money, they're your best friend.
Oh God.
Exactly. When you got extra money, they're your best friend.
Oh God. You can say that again.
You know? Or when you got a ride, they're your best friend.
You can say that again and again.
Can't stand these nigga bitches, man. Death to the nigga bitches. Oh, anybody got a
question? This is Ecclesiastes 25 and 16. I had rather dwell with a lion and a dragon.
Yeah? His brother said, man, I'd rather dwell with a lion than a what?
A dragon. Than to keep house with a wicked woman.
Yeah, man, to keep house with a wicked woman, man. These women ain't no fucking good, man.
And
he said he'd rather dwell with a lion and a dragon to keep company with a wicked woman, man. These women need to be put to death,
these
man.
That's right. Wicked.
Especially with their hair weeds.
Wicked.
Fuck these bitches, man.
And they start off real young, too.
Yeah, they start young.
Real young.
Now, this is what the book said right here. I'm continuing on page. This is Nature Knows No Color Line on page 28. It said, from a woman was the beginning of sin. And because of her, we all die. And the brother just read it in Ecclesiastes 25. 25?
25 and
24. 24, right? It said, throughout Christian Europe, this when the Dark Ages, when Negroes was ruling, generally, woman was considered an evil and enemy of faith.
That's truth. Man, that is truth, boy.
That's what these brothers said back then, man.
I seen that even in my own old soul.
Yeah.
That's truth.
Yes, yes,
I'm telling you,
man.
Society actually put these women above men. And they're feeling like they're the head. But these fucking women just wicked.
Yeah.
To ride off on that, like when you read the Daily Express, it's a newspaper out here in Trinidad. When a couple get married, they put the woman first,
right,
then the man name on the bottom.
That's, right.
That's wickedness, man.
Wickedness.
The man is first, then a woman.
That's right. Yeah, because another thing, that was another thing that came up too.
Proceed, let me finish reading it. I'll give you the floor back. It said, throughout the Christian Europe, generally, woman was considered an evil and enemy of faith. A common saying was, woman is the gateway to hell.
That's truth.
Understand?
I can say that again.
I repeat again. It said, woman is the gateway to hell. The Latin femina, woman, was interpreted as minus faith. So that's what feminine means. It means what?
Minus
faith. Faith, mina, minus. Understand? So feminine means minus faith, man. Right. These women ain't for you. I am on the side, man.
All right, hear what Yahweh say. I'll get back to you. Let me just read the scripture. Isaiah chapter 3, verse 12. And this is a concern that Yahweh was given to the nation of Israel. Look what he's saying in verse 12. Ask for my people. Children are the oppressors. And women rule over them. Women rule over them. And who ruling in the land? Who ruling over Caricom? This white bitch has so-called Queen Elizabeth. She's in head over Caricom. Yeah?
Who's ruling IMF?
IMF.
Got this old white bitch.